I will talk about Slantide. Slantide, you heard about maybe 3 years ago when we presented for the first time at a KFAIR press conference. So now I will give you an update. Where do we stand right now? What's the status of the project? And I will start with this picture here on the right, because with this picture we can explain easily what's the status of the project right now. 3 years ago, we mentioned that we're gonna build up a pilot plant to produce or manufacture this material for the first time. And now you see that the building of the pilot plant is in place, it's running, and we can prepare larger samples I presented last time, and I will go into details during my presentation. First of all, what is the idea behind why do we need new thermal insulation materials from our perspective? So as we all know, the building and construction industry face a lot of challenges, even now, but also in future. And for new buildings and also for renovation, retrofitting, thermal insulation materials are always a part of consideration, are always in place. And the question is, how do we find the right material for each and every application field, because they have to be different if we think about renovation and retrofitting, and they all have to fit into different kind of building and application systems as well, especially in the facade. BASF has a long history or tradition in thermal insulation materials, starting in the 50s with Styropor. And you will learn more about our recent innovation of Styrodur. And all these numbers are just the decades represent where we invented these kind of materials. And around 10 years ago, we discussed internally what will be the future of thermal insulation and what do we have to develop with respect to new materials properties and also to requirements. And first of all, we thought, okay, we have to develop a material with better thermal insulation properties, for instance. And as you see here, we're gonna launch our new material, Slantide, in 2020. So each and every 10 years, we're gonna have new materials for this field. And we believe that this will be a perfect extension and addition to our traditional materials. And when you want to develop a new thermal insulation material, you have to take a look at the physics or the basics of thermal conductivity in this respect. And if you want to further reduce the thermal conductivity, meaning if you want to increase the thermal insulation performance, you have to decrease the cell size by a factor of 1,000 if you want to achieve a real significant effect here, and this is shown on the left side. So standard materials, standard foams, they have pore sizes around 100 to 200 micrometer, and if you reduce the cell size by a factor of 1,000 to 100 nanometer, you really can significantly reduce the thermal conductivity of such a porous material. What we try to achieve is to develop a material with thermal conductivity values below air, even though the material contains just air. And this is only possible if you reduce the cell size. As I said many years ago, we started with new concepts, new chemistries, new physics, and learned a lot about the processes and also the physics behind such materials, and now we are ready to manufacture first quantities on our pilot plant. So, what is it all about? Slantide is a unique material. It's a polyurethane aerogel, the first polyurethane aerogel which has ever been made on a larger scale. Right now, it has a lambda value, as mentioned here, of around 17 milliwatt per meter Kelvin, which is far below air. Air has 26, and it contains just air, and compared to standard materials, as you see here, you can reduce the thickness by a factor, or let's say by 25 to 50% compared to traditional materials. It has a high compressive strength of more than 300 kilopascal, and which is also interesting in this respect, it has an open porous structure, so it contains air and can exchange with air, so there's no aging effect by the cell gas in this case. And due to the open porous structure, you can also ensure good moisture regulation, so it has an open porous structure and also ensures good water vapor diffusivity, which is also important for building and construction applications. What is the actual status and what will be the next step with our materials development? Last year, as I mentioned, we have installed and start up our pilot plant, which is in place now and which is running. There we can prepare samples of this size. So this is the largest polyurethane aerogel which has ever been made. So these are boards. You can handle it, you can glue them, you can drill them, you can cut them, you can adjust the size to your capabilities. And what we do right now is we use this pilot plant to establish or to elaborate a production plant concept which has never been built so far. So we really have to develop by ourselves. This is not myself, hopefully. What we now do is we do joint development with partners from building and construction and also with other industries to further develop this material, make it market ready. I will give you one example at the end of my presentation. And we have to find the business model. And the idea is to produce these boards by ourselves. As I said, at the moment, we elaborate the full capacity production plant. The finalization of the production concept will be next year. This is our clear target to be ready in 2020 with a market launch of that material for many different applications. One of the potential applications is shown here with our partner Beck & Hoyn. We have shown Slantide in a roller shutter together with our material Neopore. So the entire roller shutter casing is made of thermal insulation materials. Here is a combination of Neopore and Slantide shown. This is just a showcase for the moment, just to give you a flavor how you can shape the material, how you can glue it, that you really can build something out of it, which makes such a concept for a roller shutter very effective. So this could be the most energy effective roller shutter ever been made, you know, with this kind of a combination, if this comes true. Here at this point, can I show this? Here you can see a thermal wedge. So this is at the conjunction between the window and the wall. This could also be an interesting example where Slantide is perfectly suited for, especially for applications with space restrictions and where you need a certain shape. You can also use Slantide, which is much more effective for such application areas than standard materials, for instance. And with this outlook for one of the potential applications, I would thank you for your kind attention.
BASF. We create chemistry.